Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. So before you get into the montage of the best bits of the first month of Couch Potatoes, I just wanted to say thank you for any of the support that you put onto those videos, whether it be likes or comments or support on Twitter. Thank you so much. Now, I have seen that another YouTube channel has started a series called Couch Potatoes with near identical branding. There's not anything I can do about that. We just kind of have to grin and bear it, and I'm certainly not going to stop my series because it's some of my favourite content that I've done in recent years. So everything's going to be continuing as is. So as always, if you've got any games that you'd like to see us play on Couch Potatoes, then do let me know. The only thing I have planned so far is probably a miniature playthrough of Mighty No. 9 with Calf, which is the game from the old Mega Man developers. I'm also going to be checking out Gang Beasts with Area 11. They've got a brand new album dropping July 1st, so I wanted to get the four of them in the studio with me just to play a couple of games. So I hope you enjoyed this montage. If you do, be sure to slap a like on the video. And before you head off, if you can, I would appreciate it if you could head over to store.yogscast.com, pick up a Yogscast Pride shirt. All of the money from these shirts, all the money we've raised on the live streams as well, is all going straight towards the ILGA, which is one of the largest, if not the largest, organization in the world that supports LGBTI communities throughout the globe. All right, have a good one, everybody. Enjoy!
We've been pulled from the ground, now we're lounging around.
Oh, God! Jesus, oh, no!
We're Couch Potatoes.
Do you want to go to a world of magic and adventure?
Hell yeah!
Then go fuck yourself.
Oh, okay!
welcome
back to Couch Potatoes.
Couch Potatoes. And we're here in the Yog Towers with the Martin, the Little Wood, and the Sparkles.
Everything
the
has Sparkles. A blur in it. You're like an old person talking about, like,
you know,
technology.
Oh, yeah, I've been watching that YouTube channel on
put
the internet
on, but it's
TV.
On, it's on the YouTube.
On the YouTube channel, on the internet TV.
On the YouTube, on the internet, on the computer.
Oh, I'm killing him without even seeing him. I'm like a crazy man.
Okay. Considering I have a mic between me and there,
yeah,
you can
it's
hear the
be
difference really quickly. I feel like this is really important story stuff. Oh, and I pressed A.
I was going to say, like, nobody's going to be able to hear it over us talking anyway, sugar. And then you just skipped it.
Oh, you got a holo card.
I killed them first. Oh, yeah, holo card.
Damn, can we see what you got?
Oh, my. How do I... Is it,
should we do it over the top FIFA pack unpack
card
opening?
Card collection, yeah. Okay, you ready?
Yo, what's up? Today we're going to be opening some packs.
Oh, it's Pepe. Who's a footballer? Pepe, is he a footballer?
Pepe.
It's
Pepe.
Messi.
Messi. Yeah! Ronaldo. Oh, it's Ratchet. We know that one.
Super rare.
Oh, my God. Holo.
Oh, look at that. Is it actually? Okay, well, there you go.
I don't know.
That's terrible. I'll let you do that on your turn. That's fine. I'll finish this level off.
That's it.
You can do all the card sorting.
I can find how many coins I can sell it for.
I can't pick this
up. If you want cheap, reliable Ratchet and Clank screws, then go to ratchetandclankscrews.biz.net.
Martinsratchet.com.
Martinsratchet.tk, because it's a free domain.
Nice.
The city that had been plagued with...
It's almost so like, slow, you have to read it like an idiot.
I imagine it's Christopher city. Walken writing this.
Oh, it's gone.
The city.
However, evil has once again cast its shadow.
Mr. X,
the syndicate boss.
Now it's going too fast.
Why does it fade too quick?
Now it's going too fast.
They've literally gone from, like, Christopher Walken doing, you have to get to the base, to suddenly, like, that girl, that big blonde boobed girl on YouTube who can read really quick.
I've not seen her.
She's friends with Shane Dawson. She's like a world record holder and stuff. So I'm not going to know any of these, like, danky memes about this game.
Yeah, like barrel rolls and slippy and everything else. I wonder
it's
if
a
they
trap! Is that from this?
No, that's from Star Wars.
Oh. All right, it was close.
I love that straight away. That infamous Star Fox meme. It's a trap!
Fuck you, Mark!
Mark Humes is doing a nice little sexy dance.
Mark
the
from the Star
us.
Fox episodes is outside.
He's getting his balls out.
I was trying to pitch that idea the whole time.
Incident. Oh no!
I had him doing that. You don't get that on Dragon's Den.
No, that's true.
You don't get somebody like twerking Lord in front dragons. Of the door. It's like, hello there, Peter. Hello, the rest of the dragons. I've come here today asking for £100,000. It's like, okay, I like this idea, but pitch it to us whilst Sunita twerks over here. Mark! I want to see him do his twerk again. I want to get a clip of him doing it.
Do it.
For the camera.
It. Put that on Twitter.
So this is what I've been looking at.
Oh, yeah.
For the, like, that's
that sounds good.
Seconds.
Oh, yeah, check Twitter.
Whilst trying to do it.
God, this guy.
Yeah, I'm keeping it there, shaking everything.
Beautiful. This is what we get in the office.
I was saying to Sparkles before that when... Because you guys have just announced a new album, haven't you?
Yeah.
So when the album actually drops,
let's deal with this. Let's deal with the real reason I'm here to plug my shit.
So when the album actually drops on July 1st, you can go to area11.band to pre-order
it. It's literally going to drop. I'm going to
links down below.
I'm flying helicopters over the United Kingdom. And,
has anybody ever done that? Have they ever literally
I'm gonna drop my single, and it's
like they've flown over like an airfield and just dropped a load of CDs.
It's like propaganda in the Vietnam War or something, where they drop like flyers out of helicopters saying like, "Oh, America's amazing," or "America sucks."
Yeah, I honestly think that if you got a few like mega fans into a field and said, "Right, sign this waiver, so no matter what hits you, you're not gonna sue us for it," and I think they would literally let you drop their mixtape on you.
I have an exciting...
Or your mixtape on them. Oh!
Right, I'm not being weird.
What happened here? So wait, we're in an arcade, then we went on a pirate ship.
Now look at this. You punch this, you got to run the fuck away, because... And I need that so bad.
No, you don't!
Go get that.
You don't need it.
You can have the sword, that's good ass.
I don't care about the sword, you can
have the
sword.
Fine, I'll have the sword then, whatever.
I just want health.
Fine, next health is yours. There, you can get that money. I want the money as well. I'm greedy, mate. You think I got this far without being a hustler? I take the chicken and it's mine.
I'm like 50 Cent 9 times, mate.
If I want that shit,
9 times.
I take it. What, I got shot 9
splinters.
Times? Splinters.
I've had splinters 9 splinters. Times.
I've had a really life. Bad. I've had a dicky tummy 9 times.
I've been stung by nettles at least 20 times in my life.
Without a dock leave?
You think I don't know pain and suffering and hurt?
You've had a real life, mate.
I've lived. Fuck.
What have you done?
If I had had that steak earlier and I wouldn't have died there. Just
it's
wanted
right.
to know that.
It's all right. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about
you
it.
You don't care at all.
Of course I don't care.
Power and communications have been restored to the colony.
GG.
The Gorilla is ready to be rebooted.
The Gigorilla?
The Gigorilla.
Oh my god.
The Gorilla.
This like sounds like the name of some kind of like improv comedy group.
The Gigorillas.
The Gigorillas. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage. They monkey around.
They monkey around. Oh, that's so good.
It's the Gigorillas.
Hey, everybody, we're the Gigorillas. We need you to come up with a location and a theme.
Why do they sound like they're from Family Guy?
I don't know. Look, these voices just come out of me, man.
Okay, settle down, children. Today I'm going to tell you a tale.
But Daddy, what happened to Ratchet and Clank last time?
Well, that's the thing, dear. We spoke all over every fucking cutscene, and people were very disgruntled about it.
Daddy, what does fuck mean?
Why does Daddy have such a weird granny voice?
Why do you sound like a bit of a scary old man?
If you want me to sound like a scary old man, come here, sit on my lap, calf.
Daddy,
I'm gonna tell you a tale.
Bad touch.
Clank's ticklish, so he ends up Chelsea kissing Ratchet.
What's a Chelsea kiss?
That's where you headbutt somebody in
the
face.
Oh, right, okay.
And then I put, Clank's knee is busted, so he starts walking with a weird limp like Vince McMahon. This is all in one document.
Wow.
Clank tells him, Drek wants to attack the Hall of Heroes with the blog.
Oh
I
God.
Thought he was trying to beatbox dubstep, but those are real words. They go back to where Ratchet lives and they see his car. I think Exhibit could do with visiting him.
How does this work?
So I think this is just
we're just
like,
fighting.
This is just literally like Tekken.
We're just fighting.
Oh, what the fuck? You get weapons as well and the death of field. Oh, get wrecked, mate. Skate, you're about to get schooled, bro.
We're so bad.
Yeah, but what's worse about that is like you were just punching. That was my special.
So you actually hurt yourself as well doing it?
Yeah, pretty much. Do you ever get oddly fascinated by stains?
By stains?
I know this sounds weird.
I can't say I have.
The other day, I was sat on the bus, and the seat opposite me had this really horrible-looking orange funky stain. But what made me tickle, what tickled me, was the fact that it looked like a giraffe. It was amazing. Let me see. I got a picture on my phone. I can literally show you this. If I remember, I'll have this thrown up in the episode as well. Where is it? Camera. Oh, no, my storage is full.
Oh, so you are probably, you're getting shot at the moment. You need to fly down.
I?
There you go. Oh, you've done it now. Yeah,
I thought I'd already flown into it.
No. It was
mission
just
complete.
Like,
this is very important. We can't end the episode until I show you.
The stain.
The giraffe stain. I still to this day don't know what it was. Where is it?
And right? This was on the bus.
This was on the bus. Tell me that doesn't like a giraffe.
I mean, it does.
It does. It looks just like a giraffe.
Yes.
It looks very much like a giraffe. It looks like a giraffe with an anteater's face. And it looks like he's got a really giant knob just swinging down the bottom of it as well. Anyway, that's it for Gadget Potatoes for today. Cheers for watching.
Thanks for watching, guys.
We'll see you next time. Ta-ra.
Giraffe cocks.
Episode. So right now we're looking at Static Screen Sparkles.
Yep.
I'm so excited for this.
This looks really good.
We're looking at a static
proper
screen.
Proper authentic.
It's a bit warped.
Background noise from the Big Bang. You know that's what it is? You know that's what it is? Radio wave interference?
Yeah. I just thought it was a really hard to scan QR code. Can I just get your phone out and be like, just sit fucking still. I just want to see something. Let me try this.
Try with a QR?
Yeah, like I literally want to like take my phone over to it.
Right, I'm going to film you doing this.
I want to get the Google Authenticator app and then I'm going to go over. I'm going to see if I can just like scan it and see if anything works.
Okay.
Here we go.
All right, here he goes.
Scan.
Here he goes, guys.
No, it's not. I just thought like maybe like one little square might just like nail it.
Why would have this worked?
I don't know. It could.
Oh, by like chance, it might accidentally
just
do
by
it.
Chance.
Are you just killing a helpless tank?
I think so. I think I'm making his job a hell of a lot harder than it needs to be. I think he's actually just trying to wipe them all out. But I think everybody here is our enemy.
Oh, you broke him.
The weird slime dudes and the government people.
Kill everything on this new planet. We don't like any of it.
That's
get
it.
Rid of
way
it.
To make peace with the universe. Just go in and shoot shit out of everyone.
That's it. No discrimination. Just everything dies.
That's it, yeah. It's not racist if everyone gets killed. That's a quote.
Just genocide. That's fine.
Yeah.
That's little to prove, that is. 30 this year. So I think everyone has to give me £30.
Really?
I think that's how it works. Yeah, I think so.
I'll buy you something for £30.
Well, I mean, I wasn't saying you had to buy me anything, but like, well, I think that's how it works. Because when you're 60, you have to get £60.
This isn't a wedding anniversary,
is it? I thought it was a thing. Is it not like a tradition to give people certain amounts of money? Because when you turn 20, you get £20, right?
Yeah, I guess so.
And, like all your relatives will give you £20.
Yeah.
So like when
true.
You're 30, all your relatives give you £30.
I thought 21 was a bigger thing, or I guess in this country it's 18 is the big one.
Yeah, there's not really anything that happens when you turn 21 in the UK.
Can I get up there yet? Oh god.
You can rent ultra porn, that's about it really.
You can rent what wait, ultra porn?
Yeah, you can rent
ultra
porn.
Wait, how's that different to regular porn?
It's ultra. It's really quite out there.
It's just Ultron's homemade videos.
Yeah, exactly. You think you've experienced good porn when you're regular porn. No, no, no. There's a whole other shop genre.
Check out ultra porn.
Ultra porn.
More
are you 21?
Cock. Yeah. More mouth. More ass. God damn.
Holy shit, this episode went downhill quickly.
I wanna see some ultra porn.
Don't Google it, guys. But I mean Space Cowboy, so that would be what? Like that kind of sounds a bit like a homoerotic kind of.
Yeah, that'd be the Brokeback Mountain of space movies.
Yeah.
What other
It's cold tonight in space.
What other
Do you wanna have some space sex?
I got some space ice cream. It's Buzz and Terry's.
Do you want to touch my space dick? It's kind of like everything is...
No, when you go into space, everything of yours does not become space. You don't go, listen to my space fart.
If we get a chance to go to space together at some point, like if that becomes a thing where you could just go to space, dude, everything can become space.
Let's do the time warp again.
I can't remember the rest of how time warp goes after that.
Hold on to your flight stick.
And then you roll to the right.
Call that pig man a prick. And then he's going to die. Because you're a fox. And you're flying in space. Let's play some Star Fox again.
Can't let him grab me or I'm fucked.
No, that's it. Like, go. No.
Come on. Please don't let that be the end. Please let me have just a sliver of health left.
No.
Fuck. Fuck you, stupid ass worm.
See you next time on Catch Potatoes.
Fucking Will Smith, Men in Black, Subway Underground, worm ass hand, bitch. Oh, God. No, I don't want to fucking practice.
The game is literally mocking you. That's amazing.
Don't want to practice. You piss off.
Retry this mission, I suppose, if you think you're good enough.
Is that going to take me back to the start
right
of the
Right to the start, yep.
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
Oh, Jesus, a fox in the desert. I might have my usual climate. No wonder I was doing so badly. I'm supposed to be in a nice fresh water
what?
Woodland.
Water
woodland.
Ah, aquatic foxes, yes.
I know of those.
Yes. The very rare and illustrious aquatic fox.
Oh, God.
Thanks, everybody. See you next time on The Couch Potatoes.
Later on CP.
CP. Does he know CP is also an acronym for child porn?
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Maybe not later on CP. So sounds like, what's his name? Sir Patrick Stewart.
Oh, nice.
Set coordinates for the Galactic Ranger home.
Oh no, wow. Maybe not Patrick's do it.
It's a bit robot-y, but it's still a voice. A voice.
It's very like tiny, like tinny twang on it, isn't there?
Oh dear.
Tinny twang. That's gonna be the name of my new indie band.
Tingy twangy.
Tinny twang.
I like it. I like it. Maybe get some nice banjo in there.
But they use like actual like tinned foods as instruments as well.
I like it, yeah.
With their brand new album, Hindsight.
Yeah.
I can see it now. This is going to be amazing.
Use like the cans to like slide on the guitars, like wow. <Yeah.
laughs> And you got like the guys using them like a drum kit.
Oh,
he's
love
got
it.
Big peach tins.
I can imagine it. It's like one of those 70 gimmick bands, like the Wombles and stuff, isn't it?
Big peach tins. That's one of their like that's their groupie names.
Yeah, that's it. We love peach tins.
Who's a big peach tin?
I am. Yeah.
We love girls who got big peach tins.
Oh my god! I can see it now. I mean, I don't normally like just normal peaches knocking about, but peaches in syrup. I mean,
just peaches mooching around on the street.
Yeah, there's here. Like, you want to eat me? I'm like, no, I'm alright, thanks, mate.
No, I'm
right.
Good.
I'll leave it.
Spare any teeth, sir. Spare any bites. Imagine that. A peach just begging on the street.
Oi, give me your cash.
Come on, mate. Times are hard.
I'm getting furry, mate.
I'm not quite as furry as the others. They all look down on me.
As in, like, more fur is like a status symbol.
Yeah, it is, yeah. It's like a symbol of, like, wisdom as well as age, which is kind of true of humans as well.
That's it.
I see someone with a beard, I'm like, damn, that dude's intelligent.
Thank you. That's very good.
He's wise. Yeah, you got a beard. I'm the only person on this show so far who doesn't have a beard.
Oh, wow. The beardless.
We could go to some other chicken restaurant, like Nando's if you want.
Oh, we should go Grillstock, dude.
Grillstock, where's that?
Grillstock is like up at the Clifton Triangle. It's one of those like shit hot barbecue
Mission?
Places. Don't start bringing slang in here. I'm already annoyed enough at people that keep saying
lit. You hate lit, don't
you? And then when I found Litten. Out the other day when the fucking new Pokemon Litten got announced for Sun and Moon, everyone instantly were like, oh yeah, that Pokemon's lit.
Fuck off.
Dude, this is an important moment in my life. One of those guys was just called Martin.
No, with a Y.
Swear to God, with an I.
Nice, not you then.
So now I have even more reason to kill him.
Yeah, it's like the evil you or the good you.
Where is he? There he is, look! Hey, you bold twat.
There's lots of Martins.
Oh, so the funny story about the Y. So Uber...
You've been lying about it all this time.
I had the most inappropriate Uber driver the other day, but I loved him at the same time.
Okay.
So he's an African dude.
Okay.
And I know this because of the story I'm about to tell you. So okay. I get in the car and he's like, Maureen? I was like...
Maureen.
And
that
I was like,
your name.
And I was like, no? And he was like, oh, sorry, I thought it was Maureen. He's like, where I'm from... Maureen is like a girl's name or something.
Okay.
So I was like, oh yeah, sorry to disappoint. It was like, oh, I was gutted. I thought I was gonna like meet like an African woman. It was like I was really looking forward to it, and then you got in. And then he then proceeds to tell me about like he has his wife that he like keeps out in Africa. He's been married with her for like 9 years.
Where's this story going?
It gets worse. So he tells me about like his
I need that apple.
His wife in Africa. No, oh yeah, you do actually for once.
Fuck, I do.
And then he starts telling me that like obviously because she's never lived over here, and he's been here for so long, that he like cheats on his wife all the time.
Okay.
So this is an Uber driver just straight up telling me that he cheats on his wife a lot. And then he was like, oh yeah, like, you know, sometimes it's in the back of this car. And I'm like, why are you telling me this?
Right.
What the hell is going on?
That's, well, fair enough. I mean, it's not like you're going to grass on him on a YouTube video that loads of people are going to see. Probably.
Well, no, but still.
Do you think his wife watches this?
He was like telling me about all of his conquests then as well. He was like, oh yeah, like, you know, one time I had two lesbians in the back of the car and I ended up hooking up with them. And I was like, I mean, one, that's kind of impressive.
Also, that sounds like like a lie that it would be two lesbians.
Well, yeah, that's what I thought.
Two bisexual girls at best. I think that's bi erasure right there.
I've got this guy damage locked. Oh, and then you knocked me out.
Yeah, I know. You had it coming.
I swear I take more damage from you than anybody else.
I was once in a taxi and the guy was literally like, oh yeah, like I'm, you know, like apparently it is a thing that like he will have sex with people in the taxi.
Really?
And I thought that was just a porn thing.
Well, no, that is a porn thing though now, isn't it?
But no, it is. It's literally a porn thing.
Fake Taxi is like one of the most popular UK outlets now.
Right, but also, yeah, we've all seen that, right? Everyone's seen that.
Well, there's Fake Taxi and then there's also, what's the other one?
Real Taxi?
No, fake Cop as well.
Fake Cop, well, they pull you over or whatever.
Yeah, like the video is like, you know how fast you were going.
Remember Lycos, the search engine?
No.
That nobody ever used? Yeah.
I remember Jeeves.
What do you think
Jeeves is doing? I bet Jeeves is dead.
I reckon he's on crack. Yeah. He's just hanging about on the street corner. I wonder if that website still works, Ask Jeeves.
Shall I have a look?
Because it was like, yeah, have a look. Because like, it was
I'm
like,
ask Jeeves a question.
It wasn't like a search engine. It was like an asking engine, wasn't it? It was like, how many centimeters in the mile? Or whatever, yeah.
You would ask it a sentence question, and it would give you just a regular, it would give you like a bad Google results.
Yeah, exactly.
He's alive! Jeeves is alive!
Oh my god, no way!
Jeeves,
how's he looking?
He's looking all right. He's actually, I think he's dyed his hair.
Yes, hello, I'm Jeeves.
It's such a British thing, isn't it? Let's I bet you no one in America knows what Ask Jeeves is.
No, not a clue.
In the comments, let us know where you're from and whether or not you've heard Ask Jeeves before, because holy crap.
Here we go. I'm going to ask Jeeves, how many Americans use Ask Jeeves? So we're going to ask him himself. Let's see if he's going to be like humble about this.
Perfect. Here we go. Novalis. Oh, this looks quite nice. Oh, yes. Has he got
the
it?
Top result. How did they leave the Ask Jeeves toolbar? Oh, that's so disappointing.
So that is a thing that's like on most old people's computers is the Ask Jeeves toolbar.
Answers.com.
Oh, God.
How old is Ask Jeeves? Oh, and the answer is Ask Jeeves. That's an awful joke. Oh, my God.
Oh, brilliant.
He's General Pepper, not Corporal Snuggy.
He's Corporal Snuggy Waffles.
Snuggy Waffles.
Oh, but there's no time to relax. An enemy fleet is approaching, and we need you on the front lines.
Jinkies! Understood, Scoob!
Go get him, Tiger. Or Rottweiler, whichever you prefer.
Anyway,
where are these amazing voices coming from?
I don't know. Come to Papa. I'm not even tall enough.
God damn. Get up there.
That was my life up until like year 10 in school.
Well, not tall enough.
I was always the smallest kid. Right, so this is weird. I was one of the smallest kids in my year group by a clear way.
Okay.
Yeah, when we went to this like multi-school Olympics thing that we had for like, you know, track and field type stuff.
Yeah, to get up on that one.
It was basically sports day, but with other schools.
Okay.
And they sent me to do the high jump. So me barely 5'2" at the time, maybe 5'3", they sent me to do a high jump. That was a cruel joke.
Oh, so that's how, with the motion controls, you turn it as
Look
you're doing
at
stuff.
That. Not a problem. Whoa, why am I flying?
You're getting out of here.
Oh, God, I aged like 60 years as well.
Why am I flying? Oh. Hey, wanna pass me those cigarettes over there? I haven't had my smoke today.
So I did like a 10 minutes of crazy voices thing the other day, mm-hmm. and somebody wanted, they were just making really weird requests, like, do an old woman who sounds like she smoked for like 50 years.
Oh, shit.
And it was just like, hey, what are you doing? What are you doing with this? Why are you giving me these
smokes? I love
that
you have to give them like a Boston accent.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, of course.
It's a smoky city, you know what I mean? It's a smoky city. Don't use the underground. It's dangerous. You don't know what's going to be down there.
It was like Danny. There was Danny Dyer in there as well.
Oh, I'm Danny Dyer.
I was watching Celebrity Juice the other day.
Yeah.
Danny Dyer got his bollock out on it. Apparently, Danny Dyer is known for having one giant testicle, which is amazing.
And I like how this is going into the content. Like, we're genuinely talking about it.
Yeah, big time. He showed it to Holly Willoughby as well. Like, how many people can say
showed their big testicle to
Holly
Willoughby.
And to, what's her name? Oh, what was the woman that sat next to her? Zoe Ball.
Which is Zoe Ball.
Wonderful in pun-wise. It was, like, incredible. One of my earliest gaming experiences, and it's pretty bad now I think back on it, was going up into my uncle's loft. This sounds like it's going to be really dark.
Oh, God. Oh, no. Martin, that sounds bad. Okay.
My uncle's loft, he had, like, basically like a man cave up there.
Oh, cool. All right.
And he would let me play PC games on his PC.
Getting better. All right, nice.
And the first game he ever let me play was Duke Nukem.
Oh, good stuff.
And it was
the
Duke Nukem where you had, like, good the stuff. Sex cinema.
Yeah.
So, like, there's me, like,
little flash, like,
7, 8 years old. And I'm there, like, just watching that for like 10 minutes straight. He's like, you can run around. I'm like, I know.
I'm just having a good time. I'm just learning about my body.
I know, Uncle Paul. It's fine. I've never seen these before.
Oh, man.
Well, man, like, this track looks totally rad. Look at all these dudes going past on their boards, man.
Hey, Martin.
Well, that totally hot chick over there, I'm going to go talk to her.
Dude, talk to her. She's too hot.
What? Her name? Starlene.
I'm nervous.
You know it.
You know it. He's trying to impress her.
Fuck yeah, I am, bitch. No, Ratchet, that's not how you talk to people. It's really, really unacceptable.
Radical.
You see that spin?
That was pretty good.
That was a 360 no side.
Misty 360 from
Misty
Pokemon.
Misty 360.
That's it. That's good.
Oh my God, has he just done the Brock Rock? Oh my God, he's going to go for it. Dash.
The Ash Dash.
Whoa, the see-through Pikachu. That sounds like a nice way to describe like a goatsy or something. Jesus, don't ever search a goatsy if you don't know what one is.
What the hell?
It is.
Mine.
Dude.
You're too innocent to be talking about things like that.
Well,
holy
that's
crap.
What I love, like, oh, in man. Recent...
That's what I love. Goatsy, that's what I love, guys. That's what mine's really into.
Being a goatsy.
No, he's
I know,
there.
he's still there.
Come on.
Let's wait for him. Peek-a-boo!
Bam.
I kill you.
Nice.
I suddenly sound like Akbar the Dead Terrorist. Silence! Again. Bloody love Jeff Dunham.
Yeah, he's very good.
Although, like, puppets still make me a little uneasy to this day.
Do they?
You know, like, was it yesterday?
You went to go see Avenue Q.
Yeah, but I loved Avenue Q. That was good. But no, the reason that I get a little uneasy around them is because I still am a tiny bit now, but I'm a bit scared of the dark.
Okay.
And the reason for that is... The source of it is really strange. So, you know, we were singing Tots TV the other day.
There's a thing over there. Yeah, yeah.
It was actually Tots TV that made me scared of the dark.
Oh, really?
So I was watching episodes quite late one night. Like, I had all the lights off, but just the TV on, and Tots TV was on. So if people don't know, Tots TV was like this kids show in the UK where there were three, basically, puppets, and they lived in this random cottage in the woods.
Slightly French.
Yeah, one of them was French, and the other two were just English.
Yep.
And basically, one of the episodes ended once, and... all you were left with was just a picture of the house that they lived in, or the cottage that they lived in.
Right.
And it was just a still image of it for ages. So then I get off the sofa and go up to the TV to like check if it's like frozen or broken or something. And then all three of them jump up at the exact same time and shout boo. I think I might have genuinely weed a little bit. I was about four at the time, and that made me scared of the dark for a very long time. Oh, we conquered the Tower of Power. Where's that golden...
No, it's you just keep going. There's more towers.
Shit.
Tower of...
Oh, shit. That's the wrong moon. What's that all about? I thought it was circle to swing.
There wasn't a thing there.
There was no swings there.
There's no thing. You just need to hover and fly across.
Oh, I see.
There you go. Oh, my God.
I just jumped off and pressed circle assuming that I was going to get it. There's the golden screw.
Brilliant. We're going to try and sort something out. That was good. Pro
I thought if you hold X,
I thought you drowned.
I didn't die. Yeah,
I'm like,
oh no, maybe I did. I drowned in a box. How did I drown in a box?
Nice, perfect. Oh, so good.
I don't even know anymore. Where's just the combustor? The good old combustor.
So.
Nipple Clipper. Yeah, that's right. I turned him on.
Stage three clear.
Clear. All right. Cheers for watching, everybody. We'll see you in the next episode of Catch Potatoes.
See you later. Fuck off.